I come with a flaming emerald headdress of light, as one that you would consider a chief of an ancient tribe of natives. And I do this, dear ones, to engender within the earth what those who are close to the earth desire: harmony, purity, collaboration with what God created in the beginning. And who were those gods and goddesses? Indeed, the Elohim, the great us. Because we created these worlds that you see in the heavens and the one that you live upon, we hold them in the highest esteem and God vision as immaculate, as undefiled, yet as innocent and pure as a newborn child. We hold them and all life waves evolving upon them in this idyllic sense of their destiny already fulfilled, illumined in light, ensconced in divine fire, replete with all of the drippings of heaven's graces. And you, each one, are a part of this divine equation. In fact, your formula, unique to you as a God-conscious spirit, are divinely impressive from our vantage point. And each of you is essential to the divine plan and the divine matrix of the fulfillment of every planet, of every solar world, of every solar system, galaxy, and cosmic family throughout the universe. When you know your purpose, when you see with clarity that which is true and real, which is God, and you highlight it in your life daily again and again, and maintain your pure gaze upon this higher reality, then you assist us in our work, both as the creators and progenitors of worlds, and in our work and service, even in our humble offerings in committees such as the Karmic Board. You ask, why is an Elohim on this august body? Dearest ones, I reveal to you that it was Sanat Kumara himself who requested that I come and serve in order to bring the original divine blueprint or green print back to Earth, because Earth had become a center point for many laggards to embody from other systems, from fallen planets such as Maldek. And so the scourge upon Earth was so great that Sanat Kumara impelled me to come and hold that harmonic balance through my pure vision for each of you, for all life, and for nature itself, so troubled and burdened by the laggard consciousness of those who had forgotten God who had forgotten themselves, one with God, and who became embroiled in all manner of deceptive and illusory practices and nihilistic thoughts, feelings, words, and lives. We have indeed turned around this dialectic of darkness, and we are in that state of both resurrecting the earth and of bringing her to the brink of her ascension. Yet it requires that each one of you, ennoble yourselves in this frequency of perfection so that you can be an advocate of this pure and holy vision of the all-seeing eye of God. What is within your heart follows through your vision. If your heart is pure, your vision likewise will be undefiled and immaculate. When your heart is on fire for and with God, then your eyes blaze forth the beauty and the supernality of heaven, and your vision co-creates the new worlds that you seek even now while you live consciously walking upon the earth. Yes, dearest ones, what is outplayed within your conscious life is in league with and directly impacts and affects all life upon this earth. You know this law of the one. You know the import of your soul, your spirit, reconnected and plugged into God. You feel that connection, and you know your divine source, the fountain of beingness that wells up from within you, and therefore sustaining this grace, this blessedness, this belovedness, you do indeed focus within your frequency a portion of the all-seeing eye of God, where you live, move, and have your being. Consider this truth. Consider this responsibility. Consider how important you are to the divine equation every day as you outpicture love, as you fulfill love through the heart virtues that you now have. And a little rhyme to reconsider and to utilize with pure eyes, I say. Oh, how some upon earth have captured a number of the essences of what the Elohim and the great God men and women, the ascended masters, continue to objectify within the heaven worlds on behalf of mankind through the comics and now on the video screens across your world. Whether it is the Marvel characters or the X-Men, these are indicative of an ancient race, even which many of you evolved through when you had these higher powers, dearest ones. And if you reclaim them through conscious and pure living, they will be yours to utilize for the resurrection and the ascension of the earth. All cultures evolving hereupon, the entire civilization of mankind, and then a solar quickening and awakening will manifest, and there will be the new world made manifest before your very eyes. I somewhat like that character, the Green Lantern. And I love his ring, which in my case has the focus of the all-seeing eye of God within it. And if you would have it, I have prepared a replica for each of you this day, and so I offer it, place it upon your right hand on what has been called the ring finger, to utilize as a powerful energetic talisman to perform alchemical feats of God light. Where you shine forth this ring, the power of the emerald ray will go forth, investing great quotients of cosmic fire to annihilate what is untrue, unreal, and dark, and rekindle what is beautiful, divine, and holy. This annihilation is not destruction. It is the evaporation of illusion and the restoration of great purity and God beingness. So you may use this divine matrix. Imagine it, and it has a higher reality than you may even feel physically. For what is imagination? It is eye magic in action through initiates of the sacred fire who conceive and give birth through that conception of a divine green print of light, and then who work assiduously to make it a reality through their love kindled within their work and service. Yes, you are great cosmic and spiritual beings if you will reconceive of yourself as God originated you and created you in the beginning, divine, rich in spirit fire, and the living quintessences of God's own immaculate being. Therefore, dearest ones, I extend to you my love, my purity, and my vision, and Virginia herself will work to help you to maintain your own vision of yourself as clear, as pure, as one with God. Alia vamiate zaya vokiate haya ho a heya ho vianada lita me kiaya vo a aladatta vamiata lohi ha ha ho ya ho a hi ya vo a hi ha leo Ho ho ha hi ha va ni a ni a he o ha ho ha hu hi a lo a he a. I have called the chieftains of the past who have ascended over millennia and even eons of time to come to earth and to engage in spirit work. Some would call it warfare, and we would call it peacefare, in order to restore the planet Earth, Terra, and the light of divine beingness. Would you work with these chieftains of the sacred fire, dearest ones, each day?
Yes.
Then behold the work of God fulfilled immaculately through the spirit and fired ones who come once again to give birth within the earth of what is true, holy, and great, godly, divine, spirited, wonderful. I pray that you remember this heart stream and use it whenever you require a boost. And during my chanting, feel free to get up and dance as the native peoples do, for this is my dance of the sun within the earth for all. Thank you.